excited.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me excited. So what is upper supralateral boundary?
Bicep femoris.
So can you see the bicep femoris here?
Yes,
you're recording me?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. So this is the bicep femoris. And you can see it is getting inserted onto the head of the the fibula here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
What was the supramedial boundary?
Semimembranosus.
Okay. Semimembranosus is deep and going inside, and medial. See? This is the semimembranosus. This is the semimembranosus. It was attached here. Only thing is because the muscle was quite friable, so when I was dissecting it, it came off, but it was inserted here. It is inserted onto the medial tibial condyle, main insertion. And then it gives an oblique popliteal ligament, if you remember,
mm-hmm.
but we have removed that. So this is the semimembranosus here. And sitting on top of the semimembranosus, a tendinous structure. Can you see the semitendinosus here?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
It goes further down, and where does it get inserted to? Onto the anteromedial surface of the upper tibia in sartorius recessus semitendinosus. So this is the insertion of the semitendinosus at the goose foot, goose feet here. Since we talked about gracilis, this is the gracilis, but this is not a muscle of this compartment, it is a muscle of the medial compartment. Can you see, why is it called gracilis? Because it's a graceful tendon, a very delicate, that's why it is gracilis. And that's why we said clinically it is useful only for rectal incontinence, yes. So we have seen the supralateral boundary, we have seen the supramedial boundary, the semitendinosus, semimembranosus, and we have seen the insertion of this, insertion of that. What was the intromedial boundary? I know, it's strong. So can you see the medial head of the gastrocnemius here? Okay, open the door if you want. I know, you slowly get used to it. Open the door. You'll get used to it, don't worry. So the intromedial boundary, the medial head of the gastrocnemius, and the infralateral boundary,
the
lateral head of the gastrocnemius. Okay, so this is one apex of the popliteal fossa, this is the other apex.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, going right through from one apex to another, can we see something here?
Yes.
This is
the nerve.
Normally the sciatic nerve should divide at the junction of the upper two-thirds and lower one-third,
mm-hmm.
but here it is dividing a little lower down, and this is the sciatic nerve, it is continuing as the tibial nerve. And this is the common fibula. The common fibula runs under cover of the bicep femoris, and then it comes around and winds around the neck of the fibula here.
Mm-hmm.
And just now we mentioned in the class, it becomes the superficial and the deep rash. So this is the superficial fibula, which comes here. Okay. So this is the tibial. So we will talk about the tibial on Monday when we talk about the posterior compartment. So this is one content of the. In the morning I was not getting so much, but now I'm getting the, because it was collected there.
Stick one.
So this is one content of the sciatic of the popliteal fossa. Now let's take a look at another one. These are some branches, so you have already guessed it. This one. This is the popliteal artery. And you can see, where does the popliteal artery become the popliteal artery? Can you see the adductor hiatus here? My finger has gone inside it. This is the adductor magnus. This is the hamstring part of the adductor magnus, which is inserted on the adductor tubercle. Can you see this opening here? So from here, the femoral artery came through and came on the posterior side and became the
popliteal artery. The next few pictures are diagrammatic representations of the same dissection with clearly labeled structures. Please go through them carefully and note down all the structures that we have discussed just now. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. This is Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal signing out.